Today I bring you to my kitchen because in this video I want to show you how to make low carb cookies, but not whatever cookies. Cookies that are helping you in preventing insulin spikes, in raising your glucose levels, but at the same time they help you in stopping microbes overgrowth that you may have in your gut. If you suffer from parasites, candida, SIBO, SIFO, these cookies are ideal because they are not feeding the microbes with carbohydrates and sugar, and also have ingredients that help fighting those microbes and help with the die-off and the detoxification of the microbes at the same time. Because when we think about the word cookies, we always think, oh, I'm not allowed to do it because I am on a plan, I am low carb, I cannot do any sweets, I'm on a diet. But it's why we never live on a diet. We live on a lifestyle that helps you doing the transition into whatever lifestyle fits your body, the diet that fits your body, but at the same time, you enjoy what you eat. It is not about cutting, going in frustrations. It is about substituting the ingredients that we cannot eat for the ingredients that we can eat, and then we can play with them in the kitchen. And I do have a sweet tooth, so I was always trying to experiment with things that are bringing me satisfaction whenever I eat them. So yeah, here the oven, the first thing that we have to do is preheat the oven at 350 Fahrenheit or 180 Celsius. So we are gonna preheat it first. That is always the first thing, otherwise you're gonna have to wait after. I really hate that part. And then these are the main ingredients that we are going to use for our cookies. If you are always stocking the same ingredients, you are gonna be able always to cook anything. So for dry ingredients, we are gonna use coconut flour. I use coconut flour because it's one of my favorite low-carb flours, but it's antimicrobial because it's rich in caprylic acid and lauric acid that are antifungal, antibacterial, and antiviral, and antiparasite. So coconut flour is the main flour for our recipe. And some people say it's sweet, so for baking sweets, it's always good. Only zero glycemic index sweetener, stevia, or monk fruit. And believe me, I don't like stevia, but whenever I add it to baking goodies that have flour, you don't really feel it. Otherwise, go for monk fruit. We're gonna use baking powder to help our cookies growing a little bit of salt. And then we are gonna add my four favorite spices for fighting microbes overgrowth and for detoxification. The first one is ginger. Ginger, really rich in gingerol, really good for decreasing inflammation in your body, to aid digestion, decreasing nausea as well. For detoxification is one of the best. Cinnamon is really good for detoxifying, antimicrobial. So also make it a really good preservative. It's a natural preservative. Whatever you are cooking with it gets preserved with cinnamon. Then of course, clove, one of the most potent antimicrobials in the planet, we are gonna add as well. And cardamom. Cardamom is also really good for detoxification. And it's detoxifying. Mostly these spices are supporting your liver in detoxification to pull all the die-off from the microbes. And if you want to add any extra sweetness or you want to make your cookies a little bit fancy, you can use cranberries, or here what I have is dry blueberries. Yeah, you can use either way. Don't use raisins. Raisins are high in carbohydrates, so cranberries with no added sugar, or blueberries or any other type of berry that you dry. So these ones were blueberries that I put in the dehydrator at the blueberry temperature. Don't go for higher than 120 for fruits. You put them in the dehydrator for at least 8 hours, like an overnight cycle, and they become like this, dry. If you don't have a dehydrator, don't worry. Just take a baking tray and then line it with parchment paper, put your blueberries in there. Put them in the oven at the lowest the temperature can go in your oven. And then probably it's going to take about 30 minutes to 45 minutes to dry. And then after, just store them in an airtight container and you have your dry blueberries. How fancy and healthy is that? So I'm going to be using dry blueberries for this recipe. All right. And then for the wet ingredients, I'm going to be using eggs, 2 eggs. But for the vegans that are listening to this video, if you don't want to use eggs, the substitute for egg can be a fruit puree, like, for example, pumpkin puree or green apple. Green apple is lower in carbohydrates than the other apples. So green apple puree, kiwi puree could work as well. But I will go for apple or pumpkin, the best. Or you can make your egg with flax seeds or psyllium husk. Those are really rich in fiber. Psyllium is a pure fiber. So to make 1 egg, the equivalent of 1 egg with flax seeds is 1 tablespoon of flax seeds, flax meal. So it's the powder from the flax seeds. 1 tablespoon of flax meal with 2.5 tablespoons of warm water. And then for psyllium husk is 1 teaspoon of psyllium husk with 3 tablespoons of warm water. When you mix it, you are going to leave it for 10, 15 minutes over the counter until it's going to become kind of like a gelatin consistency, and that is your vegan egg. So just to calculate the proportions, 1 egg, usually 1 large egg, this is what we are using for this recipe, is about 1/4 cup. Of your fruit puree or your flax egg or psyllium egg. So that's how you substitute it. In this case, I'm going to use eggs. So let's get started. So what is very important always when we are cooking with this kind of flours, like almond flour or coconut flour, is that they absorb a lot of moisture really, really fast. So what is important is to put the dry ingredients in one container and the wet ingredients in a different container. Don't start adding everything at the same time. So we are going to add 1/2 cup of coconut flour. And when you measure your coconut flour, measure with a tablespoon. Don't put the cup inside the bag. You don't want to make it too thick, like press. It has to be kind of like a loose half a cup. So 1/2 cup coconut flour. We are going to add one teaspoon baking powder. Be sure you are getting baking powder that is aluminum free. That's very important. Aluminum is really toxic for your body. Then the next, we are going to add stevia, and this is up to taste. I'm going to add 1/2 teaspoon. I'm going to do it with the 1/2 teaspoon. But if you like it sweeter, you can add more. Or you can add even more than 1 teaspoon if it's not sweet enough for you. Because if you are used to cookies with sugar, maybe it's not that sweet. We got to get used to the real taste of the food, not the food that is masked with sauces and artificial sugar. Then I'm going to add just a little pinch of salt in there. Non-refined salt, Himalayan, Hawaiian, Celtic. Then for cardamom, I'm going to add 1/8 teaspoon, just 1/8, a small amount. The same amount I'm going to add for clove. And every time you buy spices, they have to be organic and in a glass container preferred. So you prefer the, you avoid the BPA from the plastic. So glass, 1/8 teaspoon of clove. And organic, because herbs are usually sprayed with pesticides. So you want to avoid that. And I'm going to add cinnamon, 1/2 teaspoon of cinnamon. If you like it with more cinnamon, you can add more. So I always say, based on spices, don't be afraid of spices. Just spice it up, because that is the way you are going to add flavor to your meals. And then for ginger, we didn't add the ginger yet. I'm gonna add 1 teaspoon ginger. I love ginger, anti-inflammatory. So 2 1/2 teaspoons. So 1. This is good. This smells really good already. With the spices. So basically, we don't add the blueberries yet. We are gonna mix well. You can whisk it with this, with a fork, with an electric hand mixer, whatever is better for you. Or you can put everything in a food processor, which is also faster. And I do love to do it in the food processor, but I wanted to show it like this, just in case you don't have a food processor. All right. So we have our dry ingredients well mixed all together. We put it on the side. And now we mix the wet ingredients. So for the wet ingredients, we are using the 2 eggs. Or you will use 1/2 cup of pumpkin puree or 1/2 cup of green apple puree. Or 2 times the amount of the flax egg or psyllium egg that I mentioned before. I'm going to whisk it well. So we whisk it, that gets a little bit foamy. My mother always told me, because I used to whisk like this, she told me, just put some energy in there. So whisk, whisk. Until it gets a little bit foamy. You can see there are bubbles. And then we are gonna add oil. The oil is gonna help also binding together. So we are gonna add melted coconut oil. You can also add ghee if you are not vegan, because liquid gold is how in Ayurveda they call ghee. It's really good for the gut lining. But I'm going to use coconut oil, 1/4 cup coconut oil melted. And I use coconut because, as I said, for the flour, it's really rich in fatty acids that are antimicrobial. So imagine how many benefits you have in cookies. And we always think about cookies as something that we have to feel guilty about, right? But it's not. All these ingredients are just fuel in our body, just in a form of a snack that also help us moving forward in a healthy lifestyle. All right, so we have our wet ingredients ready. So now is the time to mix the wet into the dry. As soon as we are ready to put it in the oven is when we mix the wet into the dry. So we add everything in there. And we mix it with the whisker, the fork, or you are doing it in the food processor. And if for any reason your dough is a little bit wet, don't worry, because coconut flour absorbs a lot of moist, as I said. So you just have to leave it for 5 minutes over the countertop, and then it's gonna absorb the moist and it's gonna get drier. So every time you cook with coconut flour and it's too wet, just leave it sitting on the countertop. This is pretty dry, manageable. So now is when we're gonna add the blueberries. So this is about, we're gonna add 1/3 to 1/2 cup. So depending how many you like to see in your cookies, I'm gonna add 1/3. I'm not gonna put all of them. All right. If you put too many, sometimes it's not gonna glue. I love using my hands, I have to say, whenever I'm baking. This is the best way to put together the dough. Very sticky, very sticky. I'm gonna rinse my hands. All right. So we have our dough with the blueberries, the dry blueberries or cranberries in there. And now what we are gonna use is a baking dish lined with parchment paper. Never use aluminum foil whenever you are using your oven, because the aluminum foil in high temperatures is going to release aluminum. It's very toxic. It's going to go into your food and it's going to cause a lot of toxicity to your body. So basically, I'm going to line the baking tray with the parchment paper. And with the tablespoon, the size of one tablespoon can be a measuring one or can be one of these. I'm going to use this. You're going to take about the size of one tablespoon. We're going to make a little ball. Look, it's chewy. It's not sticky anymore because the coconut has absorbed some moisture. So it's chewy. It's perfect. So then we're going to put them in here. And I lined two trays because I like them to have to be separate a little bit from each other. So let's see how many we get. So we just flatten them a little bit with our hands like this. So we are gonna do that with the whole dough. Some of them have more raisins. The one didn't have that many. I'm gonna put them on the top. So we do the same thing. And don't worry, some of them are gonna be bigger than another ones. That's completely fine. The taste is gonna be the same. Don't be too harsh with yourself when you are cooking. There's a lot of people that is scared of putting hands in the kitchen because it doesn't look as beautiful as the recipe that they are following, but it doesn't matter the look. This is all practice, practice. What is important is that taste is good for you. And if there is a spice that you are missing in there, then the next time that you make it, you can add more of that spice or more sweetener or less stevia. Now I'm gonna tell you another little secret, and I love them like that. Instead of blueberries or cranberries, you can add chocolate chips. Yeah, chocolate chips. So if you don't have histamine intolerance and you can eat cacao, chocolate chip has to be from a chocolate bar. You buy a chocolate bar that is 85% or 90% cacao, and then you're gonna put it in the food processor and chop it. And those are your chocolate chip. Because otherwise it's impossible to find clean chocolate chips that are 85% cacao at the supermarket. So what you buy is the chocolate bar, you chop it, and then you make your chocolate chip, and you can add that in your cooking instead. That's, I love them like that. All right, so we have six in here. I'm gonna keep putting this. Yeah, so there is always a substitute between vegan and non-vegan, always a substitute. It just depends what you are cooking. If you are making something crunchy or you are making something soft, if you want it as a binder. So depending on what we are doing, that is the type of substitute that we use. Flax egg and psyllium egg don't always work very well for all recipes, but for cookies, they work pretty well. Depending on the brand that you buy for psyllium husk to make your psyllium egg, it may turn purple when it's in contact with coconut. So it's kind of pretty. So you get purple cookies. All right, so we got about 9 cookies here. This one had a lot of raisins. Not raisins, blueberries, sorry. All right, so we are just going to put them in the oven at 350, was already preheated. We put it in the middle of the oven. Like this. And this cookie may not grow much, right? So we are gonna leave them baking at 350 for about 12 to 14 minutes. It depends on every person's oven, but you are gonna see that they are kind of golden on the top, and that would be it. Then after you take them out from the oven, we leave them cooling down for 10 minutes on the baking dish, and then after we take the cookies and we put them on top of a wire rack until they completely cool down. So, and this will be it. Then you have already an amazing snack that you can take everywhere, that you can enjoy for breakfast, and is at the same time fueling your body, helping you detoxifying and fighting any microbes that you may have.